Dissolves my lips. So the eye palette retail, the eye palette, really, eyeshadow palette. We are getting video bombed. My skin says, yeah, I don't like this. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today another Let's Talk Makeup new makeup releases. I feel I don't have a lot this week, but I could be mistaken. But yeah, let's start with what I have on the face. It is first off listed in the description box and the look is done with a birthday present. This one that I got from my sister. I played with her today and spoiler alert, she really good. So yeah, I know that she is sold at Beauty Bay for us in Europe. This video series is based on Samantha March's Will I Buy It series. Her playlist is listed down in the description box, as is the community playlist that she created. My sources are down there. The products that I will mention today are down there. I have some discount codes that are floating around down there as well. And that is basically it. So if you want to know anything, just hit that, you know, show more thingy. Just read the description box. That is the best thing. I feel I'm forgetting stuff. But yeah, oh yeah, I'm filming this on Saturday. And it could very well be that I have missed some stuff. Because this video goes up on Monday. Just so you know. So if you're like, why did you not talk about that? It was either I did not find it interesting at all. I didn't see it. Or I talked about it in previous videos. So yeah, my own playlist of these videos is listed down in the description box as well. So yeah, let me go to the side though. And recline so I can kind of put pictures up there. Let's start with I Heart Revolution because they are busy as usual. They have launched a bunch of stuff. Let's start with this, which is let's see, it says here, ready for your next fruity fix, fix up with the new deliciously scented I Heart Revolution fixing sprays. You get a pineapple one, watermelon. And I think that's it. So yeah, so the pineapple one is for brightening and the watermelon one is for hydrating and dewy finish and such. Fixing sprays though usually contain denatured alcohol as a second ingredient, so they're not hydrating, they actually dry out your skin. So if you're like, why is my skin dehydrated, check that. But yeah, it's not for me, but I did want to mention it because I know some of you do really like it. There are two new sprays there. The next thing that I am going to mention is this. This is their new lip mask collection. You get coconut ice. No, do not. Coconut ice, watermelon popsicle, mango smoothie, vanilla cake, cherry pie, and that was it. And they are all enriched with avocado oil. So that is very, very nice. I actually ordered one of these. I saw them on Boozy Shop before I saw them on Instagram. So I actually got the vanilla cake. It, for me, does not really smell like vanilla cake. But I do really, really like the lip mask. I also have one from Laneige. A little sample jar, the pink one. I don't really like the one from Laneige because it's almost like it dissolves my lips. It sounds weird, but that is what it feels like. So if I put a Laneige one on at night, then in the morning I'm like, what happened? It's weird. I don't have that with this one. And I have been using it now for, I think, 3 days. I really, really like it. I really like it. So yeah, it's quite a bigger jar as well. If you like lip masks, try these out. I really like these. So yeah. Okay, let's go next to another release from them. Because they have released a few new palettes as well. They have a peach palette. They have a peach mini. And they have an avocado mini. So maybe they will bring out minis from all. Or do they already have minis of the other ones? I don't know. I do know though that if you live in the Netherlands. At least where I, in the tiny drugstore that I go to, this range is in the local drugstores now as well. They sell it at Kruidvat in stores. I haven't seen the peach one yet. I also have not seen the minis because I'm actually interested in the minis. The peach one, let's look at it, does look really pretty though. The peach mini seems to contain shades that are not in the bigger palette. So yeah. That is actually a very good idea, I think. And then let's check the avocado. Same thing for the avocado one. So, yeah. I really like it. The avocado has three mattes and then the rest are shimmers. Oh, no, do not. Here I have them side by side. And the same for the mini peach. And I think it is good that they put in shades that are not in the bigger palette. So you can use them as companion palettes or just on their own, you know. I have touched on this though in my So Dope. An avocado kind of comparison that I prefer the Makeup Obsession So Dope palette just because it is a cardboard packaging. The pans are magnetic and I feel that the quality is just a little bit better than the avocado palette. But I do really like the avocado palette and I do really like these mini palettes as well. So yeah, the peach palette also looks really pretty. I technically should get the peach palette to complete the collection that I have going on here. Because I have all the Sweet and Tasty palettes. Oh, I also have prices. So the mini palettes retail for $9 or £6. And that is, say, I think 7 or 8 euros. Usually it's kind of in between. So yeah, and then the bigger palette retails for £10. I think it is 11 or 12 euros and then $15. It doesn't say so in this post, but that is usually the way that they are priced. So let me know down below what you think of it. Okay, let's go next to Cloud Beauty Company. They have just released two new hand-pressed palettes inspired by the French aristocracy and the French Revolution. So the top one is called Versailles and the bottom one is called can I say that in French? Because I want to say revolution in English. Revolution, I think, and then Français. We got French at school. If you live here in the Netherlands and probably in Belgium as well, the standard languages we learn in school are English, obviously Dutch, but also German and French. That is just what French is probably because way back in the day, the royal houses were connected or something like that. I don't really understand why we still get French here. But I did get French at school. I was actually really good at French. I loved the language as well, but yeah, I only had it for 2 years and then it's Ctrl-Alt-Delete, you know. It just doesn't stick. But sometimes pronunciation is still kind of in my mind. So yeah, that's rambly. Let's look at the eyeshadow palettes. I actually like the Versailles one, the top one. I think it's really, it's really pretty. It's a bit murky and I don't know, I really like it. The bottom one though, it does not. The top one calls to me more, the Versailles. I would love to go to Versailles, by the way, and check out the palaces. But yeah, the top one certainly calls my attention. Do I know what they retail for? Let me see if I can find out for you. So the palettes retail for $32, which is a little higher priced, yeah, but if they are hand-pressed, yeah, you know, it just takes time. Let me know if you have tried anything from them. Maybe you have even tried these. Let me know. I'm very, very curious. So, yeah. Okay, let's go next to Gimme Glow Cosmetics. Because they have released new shades of single eye shadows. And there are some olives in there. The shades are Last Summer, Fireworks, Olive You, Joker, Savage and Concrete Jungle. And they retail for $7 each. These are so pretty. So I had to change my battery pack and I hope the frame is kind of still the same. But I don't know. So yeah, I was talking about Gimme Glow Cosmetics. I would love to own these. On the picture that I am looking at though, Olive You and Savage kind of look close together. The undertone is different though. But it's, and I think it is the picture. Because I think Savage is more yellowy. Murky yellowy. And then the Olive You shade is more of a greenier one. I don't really know how to explain it, but sometimes you get the green olives, but you also have the grayish, yellowy green olives, you know? And I'm very bad at explaining it, but the shades look gorgeous. Gorgeous. Okay. Let's next go to Glamfice Cosmetics, because they have launched their UV Pastel Retro Liners. You see a picture here of an arm in normal light and UV light, so you see that. You can get it only in a bundle at the moment, and it retails for $45, but singles will be made available in the future. I think these are cute. It's not that I specifically go somewhere where there is UV light. But yeah, I do really like these pastel shades. Now, I know that they are pots, but I don't really know if they are water activated or not. They look to be water activated, but I'm not sure. I don't know. So if you do know, because maybe you have tried them already, let me know. I don't itchy chin. They look really, really cute, guys. So yeah, that's basically what I wanted to tell you about. Okay, let's next go to this. This is from Lethal Cosmetics. When I saw this picture, the first one I thought of, because I saw a tiny picture, was, oh, ABH. Did I miss an ABH palette? And then I saw the picture bigger and I thought it looks like Violet Voss as well. Let me know what your thoughts are. I think that if they had embossed it with their sign, you know, that they have in their singles, it would have made it visual for me that it is Lethal Cosmetics, because if I look at this, I don't see Lethal Cosmetics in here. But yeah, maybe it is different for you. It is, however, a collaboration between Lethal Cosmetics and Yolina. I don't know who Yolina is, but yeah, it is live already. So the eye palette eyeshadow palette retails for €39. The lipsticks retail for €16 and you get two shades. Then the lip gloss is in one shade and retails for €15. I have mixed feelings on this. Let me know what you think down below. Okay, let's next go to Glossier, because they have released already, I think, Skywash Sheer Matte Lit Tints. They retail for $18 each, or you can get two for $30. In 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 shades. It is a liquid to powder eyeshadow that gives a diffused soft effect. And it says here, why is it special? Powder finish formula that doesn't feel powdery. Smooths on with a doe foot applicator. It's silky, a blendable color, melts into skin, creating a pretty diffused effect that lasts. Yeah, a little bit, add some depth to the eye area, add more for a refined modern wash of color. So basically you can build them up. But yeah, basically it is kind of like an eye tint that you can build up. Yeah, it sounds interesting. I'm not going to get it, but it does sound interesting. Let me know if it is interesting to you. Okay, let's next go to Too Faced, because this is a sneak peek of their super coverage concealer. It's a new Peach Perfect Instant Coverage Matte Concealer, and it's coming soon. It's waterproof, sweatproof, non-whatever, and crease-proof for 14 hours. Oh no, someone is coming into the room. We are getting video bombed. Hello, my darling. Why are you growling? Why are you licking my head? Do not do that.
The birds are spies for the boulangerie.
Yes. Of course they are.
Yes.
In case you are new, because I know I have some new people, that was my son. He likes to video bomb from time to time. So yeah. Where was I? Oh yes, I was concealers from, what was it again? Two-faced, yes. Peachy. You can use your 08. It's lightweight, soft matte. So I kind of like the lightweight fact, because a lot of the time I have tried some pot concealers, and a lot of the time they're very, I don't know, a heavier and a thicker consistency. I don't like that. But maybe these are nice. But yeah, it's peach, so probably scented. I don't really want anything scented or here, but that is me. Let me know if you are excited. I don't know. Oh, they have also created a brush to use with this. So yeah, more to come. Stay tuned for launch date and all that goodness. So yeah, let me know if you are excited. I think it is, I don't know, the era of cream pots again. I don't know. Let's next go to Catrice. Did I not already have something from Catrice? No, I did not. No. So Catrice are launching a bunch of new things, but this one I forgot to mention last week. This is already available in stores here in the Netherlands, but they are also going into skincare. They have three things. They have a hydro plumping serum, a balanced hydro spray, and a glow boost serum. I have checked these out in stores, and while the ingredients look nice, unfortunately they also contain fragrance, so that is why I don't have them. That is the reason. So yeah, the fragrance was it the last ingredient or almost the last ingredient? It was very, very low on the ingredient list. For the rest, the ingredients were nice that they had in there. I just wish that brands would stop adding fragrance into skincare. But yeah, so that could be a sensitizer. Also, I'm personally not a fan of hyaluronic acid serums. I found out that it really dries out my skin, even though I'm living at the coast and it's also always kind of, well, wet here. It dries out my skin, so I don't really like it. I don't mind it if I have it in products, but I cannot have it in too many products. So if I have it in a serum and then in a moisturizer and then in a foundation, my skin says, yeah, I don't like this. That is kind of what my skin does then. So yeah, that vitamin C, I think it will be a nice for a lot of people, but for me it's not potent enough because I am used to, I am used to more potent vitamin C stuff anyway, so this just doesn't do it for me. But yeah, again, ingredients looked nice, but I don't like the fragrance in there. So that was basically what I wanted to say. They have a bunch of new stuff. I also got a bunch of new stuff from them. That is going to be in a separate video. I don't know when. I have to film it yet. There, so just so you know. Last week I talked about Huda Beauty, and I only had a picture of one of her new pastel palettes. I have a picture of them all now. So you have the lilac, the rose, and the mint. There has been some controversy surrounding her, as usual, I think. I'm not going to go into that because, frankly, I don't care. And I just want to talk about the eyeshadow palettes. So yeah, I like these. I like the color stories of these a lot. I also mentioned last week that I have two very, well, one amazing pastel palette, and the other one that I have is fantastic. It's very, very good. But yeah, I'm not my holy grail, so I don't need these. But they do look cute. I like the color stories in here. Yeah, they will release March 1st. I think they will retail for, what was it, $29 or something. And from my understanding, the shimmers in here are new or sheerer or toppers. I don't know. I should have looked it up. Let me see if I can find a little bit more information. Oh yeah, so she has created a new metallic jelly formula and a stunning tie-dye swirl shimmer that gives a gorgeous high shine finish. The shimmers are sheer with insane sparkle that layers beautifully over the matte shades to add shine and dimension. That was the information that I was looking for. So she has new formulas in here. I also said last week that her formula is a lot of the time hit or miss. if they were cheaper, I would have tried one. Because I really do like these. I really do like the color stories in here. I think they are very, very cute. But yeah, I will wait reviews first. And maybe I can, I don't know, find a dupe on AliExpress in a few months. And then I know that, especially if it's from Beauty Glaze, I know that it's going to be good. So yeah, that was basically what I wanted to mention. Let's go to Classy Cake Cosmetics. She's a very, very tiny indie brand, a one-woman show. So yeah, she also has a YouTube channel. I will leave her YouTube channel down below as well. But this is a picture of their new lip components. They look like a piece of candy. And it's very, very cute. They will be filled with glosses. The formula is vegan. The plumping version has 100% all natural peppermint oil added for the plumping effect. Okay. The components hold 13 milliliters of gloss. The standard gloss retails for $12 and the plumping gloss for $14. You can choose from any shade on her website as well as 14 different flavors. I will link the website down below as well. So yeah, so it's not really a sneak peek. It's just a picture of her packaging, and you can order them already. So I will leave again all the information down below. So yeah, very, very cute. Go check her out because she's very sweet. Okay, the last thing that I have here is from Wake and Bake Cosmetics. Her website is live, so she's new. That was what I wanted to mention. She's based in Toledo, Ohio. And she knew. And I have here a picture of one of the sheer lip glosses. And it's called Purple Haze. It's one of the new sheer lip glosses. Yeah, lip glosses, not lip glosses really. It's very difficult to talk and I'm also getting hungry. So there's that show. So she has launched a bunch of lippies. Does she have more? Let me check. She has falsies, lippies, lipsticks. I think liquid lipsticks as well. So I will leave her site down below. Because yeah, lippies and falsies. That is kind of what I see on the Instagram. Go check out the site. And yeah, if you order something, let me know how it is. That was everything that I had this week. Again, don't feel like I had a lot. So I could be a little bit more rambly. Or something along those lines. But yeah, that was it for me. This was, I think, number 76, if I'm not mistaken. Or maybe I am. I don't remember. But yeah. I'm so hungry. This was it for me. Let me know down below what you thought of the finds that I had. Did I miss any? I don't know. You can always follow me on Instagram. Tag me in anything that you find interesting. But better yet, send it through DM. So I can really see it, you know. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. And I will see you very, very soon in my next one, which will be tomorrow. Have a fabulous day. Bye, guys.